Hello guys, hope you're all well. Happy Easter. It's the Easter weekend, it's a Saturday, and it's about 1 in the afternoon. Windier than I expected, so apologies if there's any wind noises on the camera. I have to get that sorted out on this phone. Before I forget it, just gone past 400 subscribers on the channel. Cheers, absolutely brilliant. I think it's about 421, I think, last time I checked this last night. So yeah, thank you for your support. So today I'm in a nice little village called Seema, and it's in Suffolk. It's not far over the border from Essex into Suffolk. So yeah, this walk is Seema and the Brett Valley, and it's a country walking cut out walk. And sorry about the camera wobbling, it's 8 miles, should take me 3.5 hours. And the map you're gonna want for this walk is OS Explorer 196, Sudbury, Hadley and Dedham Vale, Lavenham and Long Melford. So I just ordered myself some new maps. Can't go wrong with an OS Explorer map. They're brilliant. Got them cheap off of eBay, brand spanking new. This is a walk of contrasts. The first section traversing a patchwork of mixed farmland before meandering across a traditional water meadow. The second section crosses more intensively farmland in larger uniform fields before returning to the more diverse landscape around a pretty little hamlet of Seema. Okay, so as Tommy said on the last day walk, let's get ready to ramble, let's get ready to walk. Well, I've just come through the water meadows and all the lamb fields, and I've come out to this lovely, lovely river here. I believe the house is just through there. I think that's Nedging Mill. And yeah, I'm following the river now into another little village called Chelsworth. Look at that, that's lovely. about 20 past two in the afternoon. Sun's really come out and I've just entered the lovely little village of Chelsworth. Here's this really old, weak bridge. There's the river there. This is nice. And straight ahead is the pub. So if it's open, you know what's going to happen. I'm going in there, of course. Look at this, and that's someone's private garden over there. That's not bad. Right, to the pub. I've just stopped in the Peacock Inn in Chelsworth. £2 for half a pint of Aspal. I'm just walking through the village now. It's absolutely lovely here. A lot of old houses as well. Quickly cross over. It's quite busy up there with the road. Look at this old house here. Absolutely amazing. So yeah, I'm heading towards Bilderston now. Slightly bigger village by the looks of it on the map. I'm just on the outskirts of the next village, Bilderston now. And this is St Mary Magdalene's Church. And this, I'll just get past the trees. This, the tower of the church is unusual looking. And there's a reason for that. St Magdalene's original tower collapsed in 1975, and the wooden box housing the bells looks a bit incongruous. So yeah, that's the reason for that then. Just zoom in and get a better look. Oh, there we go. So yeah, collapsed in 1975. And yeah, I'm gonna go in. Hopefully it's open, and there's apparently some pictures of it all and like sort of a story of it. So we'll have a look in there. So this is the picture of the church, inside the church, when the tower collapsed in 1975. So you can see it caused quite a lot of damage there. And yeah, there's this little plaque on the wall. The day the Bilderston Church Tower fell down, Thursday the 8th of May 1975, Ascension Day. Thursday the 8th of May 1975, European Architectural Heritage Year, was a calm day following 3 days of high winds. 3 hours after the congregation had strolled away from a communion service at the parish church of St Mary Magdalene, the tower collapsed, crashing through the nave in a tangle of scaffolding. After weathering 5 centuries, builders were working on the church tower, preparing to put in place a concrete structural beam to strengthen the tower, following an £8,000 appeal launched 2 years previously. The 6 bells had been removed, as they had been swinging north-south, the weakest way for the tower, instead of the usual east-west, and stored in the rector's cellar 2 years previously. "We were due to start work on the tower last autumn," explained the rector, the Reverend Lionel Pratt. It's a good name. "Then it was delayed. Even the diocesan architect didn't know danger was so imminent. The day it happened, it was a quiet morning. When we came out of the communion service, the builder came to me and said he was very worried about movement in the cracks. They were still working on the tower when suddenly everything went quiet. It must have been a sort of builder's sixth sense that warned them. Then after the dead silence came a rustling sound from within. Little spurts of mortar were coming from the cracks. They realised what was happening. With 1 minute to spare, they leapt over the wall and saw everything come down. For the first time in 500 years, no one climbed the hill to church that Sunday. Local school children traditionally visited the church on the morning of Ascension Day, but on this day in 1975 they did not appear. Some say this was a miracle. An Ascension Day Appeal Fund, ADA, was set up to raise money for the restoration of the tower. 22 years later, and with the help of the Lottery Fund, which awarded £232,000, English Heritage, Historic Churches Preservation Trust, and many other organisations and individuals who gave and ran money-raising activities, work was able to start on restoring the tower. A service of thanksgiving for the completion of the tower and the rehanging of the bells, which had not been rung since 1930, was held on Advent Sunday, 30th of November, 1997 at 3 p.m. And there you go. That's a little bit of history on this walk. History of St. Mary Magdalene Church at Bilderston. It's quite something, that. I've never heard of a church where that's actually happened before. And there's the photo to prove it. Right, let's crack on with the walk. I'm just outside the church now in the graveyard. And this big pile of rubble here, apparently, according to one of the parishioners, is a pile of rubble from the tower when it collapsed in 1975, and it's been left there. Some rabbits over there. So yeah, don't know if you can see that in the glare of the sun. So just round the back of the church. Yeah, fascinating little piece of history, that. Right, let's crack on with this walk. Well, I'm just entering Bilderston village now. A lot of old houses, as you can see. The weather, well, the wind's died down and the sun's out in full force now, so it's getting rather warm. Okay, this is the old market square in Bilderston. Well, I'm outside the Crown in Bilderston and it looks like it's open, so I'm heading in. Another drink, good times. So I'm in the Crown Inn at Bilderston. I've got half an aspal, £1.95, cheaper than the Peacock Inn by 5p. So yeah, I'm just gonna stop here for a little bit. I've got about half the walk left to do still, and it's nearly 4 o'clock, so I'm gonna get a move on. Chat to you in a bit. Just entered the pretty little hamlet of Seema, and down this track here is the church at Seema. Unfortunately, I haven't really got time to go and have a look in there. I've got to go down this road here. Basically, Hollow Trees Farm, like the cafe and all that stuff, where I've parked the car, it shuts at 5:45, and I've got about 15-20 minutes, so I haven't really got time, unfortunately, but just quickly show you again. I'll try and zoom in. I've taken a photo, so that will be in there, but it's literally of this angle here. And there we go. Cockerel crowing. So yeah, unfortunately, I haven't really got time to go in there at the moment. There's also a really nice pond here at Seema. You can just see there. It actually looks further away on the camera. Just zoom in. Just see it through the trees there. Yeah. It's in like this wooded dell, the hamlet. Some of the houses look really old and like run down, and then some of them, like those ahead of us here, look really well kept and stuff. And Mark Sutcliffe is right about one thing. Yeah, the lovely hamlet of Seema, nestling in a wooded dell, echoing with birdsong. And that's literally all I've heard since I got here, is just birdsong. It's absolutely lovely. one final climb up this steep road out of Seema. And yeah, I'm nearly at the end of the walk, nearly back to the car. This walk's been better than I thought it would be. I always say that about all the walks, but this one, I didn't, looking at it on paper, I didn't expect too much of it. And I got here, I was like, actually, this is pretty decent. There's quite a bit of variety of landscape. Highlight of the walk for me has got to be Chelsworth and the river and the water meadows surrounding that near the beginning of the walk. I thought that was, yeah, that was the best bit. Seema, the hamlet just back there, that was really nice as well. And Bilderston was quite nice. It was quite a big village. There was like hardly anyone around. It was almost like a ghost town, which is a bit strange. Pretty much everything else has been farm fields really. You've had some really nice views looking out across all the fields and everything, like the rolling valleys and dips and minor hills. But other than that, yeah, sort of the settlements have been really nice. It's usually always the case on these walks. And here we are back at the start on the last car in the car park. So yeah, last one here. My car is here. There we go. Right, all that leaves me to say is cheers for watching, guys. I hope you've enjoyed this one. Thank you for getting me to 400 plus subscribers. 500 is the next big one, okay? So I'm going to do something special for that. So yeah, thank you for watching all the videos and commenting and sharing stuff. Thank you very much. Right, cheers for watching. See you in the next one.